Hello, I'm Chris Menard. I have a great new feature to show you. This is Microsoft Copilot in Excel. It'll now generate formulas for you. You'll see me run through several different exercises. Before we dive into this, two quick announcements. Announcement one is you can catch me and my friend Melissa live on October 29th. We'll be streaming on both YouTube and LinkedIn. No registration is required. The links will be down below in either the YouTube video or the LinkedIn post to click to sign up and get notified about it. Item two, if you want to catch me live and in person, I'll be at the EA Ignite Conference in Nashville, Tennessee. This will be hands-on training, one day in Excel and one day in Copilot. And again, I'll put that link down below. Let's dive into this video right now. So generate formulas with Copilot is slowly rolling out. Right now, I've been testing it. It only works in Excel on the web. It did not work in my Excel desktop, but this just came out. It will work in the desktop at some point. I have this file open. I have last name and first name in columns B and C, and I decide I want to join those together. So I'm going to insert a column, name the column, and then the minute I do the equal symbol in cell D2, Copilot says generating a formula with Copilot, even has a keyboard shortcut. It is extremely fast, and it says it's going to take the first name, and it's going to concatenate with it a space bar and the last name. Perfect. Press enter, and if you take a look, that is complete. If you're saying, Chris, couldn't you have flash filled? Yes, but if I go and start changing names with the Excel function, the concatenate, they will change here. So that was an example using text. Let's do another one. I have invoice dates in column 8, and I decided that I would like to see the month. Again, I'm going to just do the equal symbol, let it generate. Let's see what it comes up with. And it wants to use the month function on the invoice date. That is perfect. Let's see what I get here. I should get the number 4. Dates or numbers, just simply highlight these. They're all correct. And you could either go, and I'm just going to do general. I'll center those for you. I'm looking at them. They are correct. Example number 2 with the invoice date. I got the month, and that was correct, the month function. But maybe I want to use the text function and have April spelled out or April abbreviated. So when I do equal and it starts generating the formulas, it's probably going to give me exactly what it did. I'm going to start typing in the word text. And if you notice right there, the text function has two arguments. It's taking the invoice date in cell H2, and then it's showing me that it's going to do a 3-letter month. So April would be APR, August would be AUG. That looks good to me. Press enter, but I didn't have to type this out. It did it for me. And there are the months. And by the way, it did take them all the way out. You could come in here and just tweak that and they all change. That is very easy to do. Next example, let's go do something with some numbers. In this file, I've got invoice in column E and I've got cost in column F. I possibly want to know what is the profit, the invoice minus the cost. I want to point out something. The two previous exercises, or three actually, that I did, I was working in a table, and that's why I calculated column and went all the way down. This time, I don't even have a table. It doesn't say anything about table design up here. Here was the previous one. It said table design. So back here, I'm using a range. I'm going to go to cell G, equal again. Let's see if Excel is smart enough to take E2 minus F2, and it is. Press enter. We don't get a calculated column, but just autofill that down. I'm going to stop here, but you can see that it is working. So there's the profit. Perfect. Keep on going. I'm kind of curious. We'll figure out the percentage. Be very descriptive with your header row names or your label names. And it is taking G2, which is the profit, and it's dividing by the invoice amount, which is the profit percentage. There is your 21%, and I could autofill that down again. But I am loving this automatically generate my formulas right here. Got one more since I'm looking here. In this spreadsheet, the opposite of the first one, I've got the reps listed in column C, but I can't sort by last name. Let's see if it can figure this one out. I would have used probably text after, but they're going to use the write function with the len function using find also. That would work too, by the way. There you go, right there. Perfect. So I am giving this new Copilot in Excel feature a thumbs way up. I could have done all of this myself. I've been using Excel for years, but if you're maybe an Excel basic user, Excel even an intermediate user, and you don't know some of this, plus I will give it this. It's still faster for me. So if I start doing equal and it fills in the function for me like it did with text, that's a huge time saver. Hope you enjoyed this video. My Excel online training classes are available, including Copilot, Microsoft Teams, and OneNote. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.